Hello guys, and welcome to Python Programming Tutorials by Amul's Academy. So in the previous tutorial, we discussed about the assignment operator and shallow copy. And today in this tutorial, we are discussing about the deep copy. So first we'll see what is deep copy, then we'll see the example, then we'll see how it actually works. Okay. So deep copy is a method of copying. And it creates a new object and recursively adds the copies of nested objects present in the original elements. Okay. So it will copy the nested object. In the shallow copy, we face the problem when we use the nested list, compound objects, right? So here in the deep copy, when we take nested list, it will copy that. That's why we won't face the problem. Okay. So we'll take the example and we'll see how it works. Then you'll understand this definition. Okay, so now we'll take few example. So to use deep copy, we need to use deep copy function from the copy module. So for that, I need to import copy module. Fine. So first I'll take a simple list. Okay, like this. So next I'll create the copy of it. So copy, this is the module name, dot deep copy. So here I need to mention list 1. Fine. So now if I check list 2. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4. We got the 2 set of data. Fine. So now if I check ID of list 1. Whether it is equal to ID of list 2. False. Because list 1 and list 2 are two different objects here. Okay. As I said, deep copy creates new object. So these both are two different objects. Now, if I try to add any element, I'll append value 10 to list 2. Okay. So now if I check list 2, a new value is appended. That's fine. If I check list 1, we can see no changes. Okay. So it will work for the simple list. Usually this deep copy is used when we want to copy nested list or compound objects. Okay, so now we'll see that example. If I take a nested list, okay, so I'll copy it. Okay, so now if I check list 2, it contains two set of data. So if I check ID of list 1, both are different. Okay, so now if I do any changes to the list 2 in the nested part, okay, so I'll change 0, 0, the first value of the nested list. Now it is 1. Okay, so I'll change it to a string. Okay, so now if I check list 2, it is changed. Okay, if I check list 1, it is unaltered. Okay, this is we wanted, right? So our original data is saved and we did the modification on the another list. Fine. So now we saw what is deep copy and we saw a few example also. Now I need to know how it actually works. So if I take a list like this, so here we'll take, this will be list 1, it contains 3 elements because 0, 1, 2, okay. So here first will contains the reference to another list, okay, and it contains 1, and here it contains 3, this contains reference to 4. Okay, here the list 1 contains one ID like 001, this contains 001, 002, 003. Okay, and this will be 0102. Fine. Next, when I do deep copy, it will create another list. It also contains 3 elements and first here we can see a nested list. When it is seen in a nested list, it recursively copies the object. So it will create a new object. So this object will contain some different ID. So here if contain 002, okay, this is the 001, right? It will be something different, 0012, okay? So it will copy this object, nested object. And next, here, this will copy these values, okay? It contains 01 and 02. Because deep copy won't copy the immutable objects like integers, strings, okay? It won't copy that. It only copy the nested objects, mutable objects, okay? So here mutable objects is list, so it copied that, but it won't copy this immutable objects. So it refers to the same value, okay? So it contains 0012. Here it contains 0102. Okay, next here we can see 3, okay? So an immutable object, so it won't copy it. It will take the same reference, 002. Here next we can see 4, so it won't copy that, it will refer to same value, we'll get 003, okay? So we'll get deep copy like this. So when I want to add any data here for the nested copy, for example, if I change the list 2 of 01 as Amul, as we did in the example, so here a new object is created called Amul, okay? It is a string. So now it has its own address, right? Like I'll take 03, okay? So we are doing the changes on list 2, okay? So list 2 has its own ID. So here we are changing in the one index, okay? This is the one index, this is the zeroth index. So this will now contains the address of this 03. And it will point to this now, okay, Amul. If I check list 2, we'll get the 0th and 1 position as Amul. But here we can see list 1, this nested list part has its own ID. So it is still pointing to this value. So it won't change the list 1, okay. So in this way, we'll get the output. Here we can see in the list 1 and list 2, it has its own ID. This nested list part has its own ID, that's why if I do any changes here, it won't affect the another list. So this is about the deep copy, how actually it works. When we have immutable objects, we can use assignment operator. Actually, there will be no need of copying the immutable data, but if you want, you can use assignment operators. For the mutables, like simple list, we can use the shallow copy. For the mutable compound objects, okay, like nested list, we can use deep copy. Here usually we don't want to copy the immutable objects because the immutable objects won't change, but the name given to this immutable object can be changed, okay? That time we may lose data. That case we can use assignment operator to save the original data. So that's it for now. We discussed about the assignment operator, shallow copy, deep copy in detail. So that's it for now, guys. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I will meet you in next class. Till then, take care.